Here we go. Hey, and welcome to another video. It's been a while, it's actually quite a while since we've made a video. We've been doing all the Christmas and New Year things, so Happy New Year, Happy Merry Christmas and all that nonsense. Today is the January the
24th,
and we are in the car on our way to Cromwell for a 4-day holiday at Debbie's friend's holiday home. In front of us is Ryan, Ariel and Sophie in their car. Gossip, what has been happening with the Joneses, what have we been doing and what are we up to? Well, first off, Debbie's mum is, how's your mum?
She's okay, she's in a rest home in Tauranga, and seems to like it and all that up there. She's well, as can be expected, I suppose. She still has a lot of back problems, but the reason for her being there, you know, she was in hospital. They think that she had, I don't know if we've talked about this before, but she had multiple little strokes, so that's why she was in hospital in the first place. But she's sort of come right, but she's kind of losing her marbles a little bit, slowly, but you know, every day she's like, you know, she'll talk, well, I'll talk to her probably like 2 or 3 times a week. What's that?
Oh, Ryan.
What was that?
I wanted to stop with her cherries and peaches and nectarines.
Oh, yeah.
We remember that on the way home.
Yeah, so she's okay, she's pretty good, apart from losing her mind, but you know, come to the best of us, I suppose, eventually when we get a little bit older. Yeah, that's what she's doing.
Right, might as well continue and get them the information about Ryan, our older son, who's in front of us right now in the car. I will flick you around.
There you go.
That's his little green holder right in front of us. Him and Ariel and Sophia in there.
Yeah. So, Ryan recently went up to Whakatane to visit Ariel's dad for New Year's, which is his sort of yearly thing they do. And then he went and visited his nana, who's at the rest home in Tauranga, and she kindly gifted him a diamond ring.
A beautiful diamond ring.
A very beautiful ring.
Wow.
And for the intention of him to ask Ariel to marry him. And that's why she gave it to him. And it was all very hush-hush and didn't want her to find out, and she had absolutely no idea.
Keep all these secrets from her.
Keep all these secrets, and we had to lie, and oh God, it was awful.
Yeah, it was.
But, you know, at the end of the day, he bought it back, and he got it sold.
Wait.
Sorry about that old blip.
Ryan just rang us.
We had to answer a call. So, what was that? He got the ring, and he's got it all sized up, and he was waiting for this friggin' ring to turn up, and then he finally got it back, and he proposed a couple of days ago,
two or three days ago,
and we're all like, oh thank God,
and Ariel said yes,
and she said yes, so which is the main thing, and so yeah, they're engaged now, which is really cool. We're all so happy, I'm so happy for them. And
it's really cool, it's really
it's
neat.
Really cool, and you know she's always been good to us and gonna be our future daughter-in-law, even though she is already, but you know.
Righto, we're just here guys because everyone wants to go for a piss break, and then we'll come back to you shortly. There's Ryan now hopping out of the car, and there's Ariel now hopping out of the car. And you're just about to see Sophie hopping out of the car, so that's them all hopping out of the car. So we'll see you shortly to come back to you. Alright, sorry guys, we're doing phone calls and we're stopping. Ryan's been down here like 4 years and done this trip heaps. Me and Mum haven't. We did this, we went to Cromwell once. If you go back to our videos, when we came down to Dunedin for a trip on the plane, we went to Cromwell House then. But we haven't been down here since. So yep, so Ryan is engaged. Not that this has happened yet, but we're nearly in March. March the 18th is Mum's birthday. It's her big birthday. Am I saying your birthday?
Yeah.
It's her 50th. My 50th is this year as well. Renee, our oldest daughter, is flying down for her 50th. So that's something else. And last time I spoke to you, I was relief milking. I haven't been relief milking for the last month. I actually went for a job on a farm, sort of casual, just to make a bit more money, and then got offered the manager's role on the farm, which means I am in charge of five staff, well, that includes me, so four others, a 1,000 cow farm, in shed, living in winter, and the biggest farm I've ever been on in my entire history of life, like three times bigger than I'm used to. My shift I used to do in River Kaitu where we lived was 12 on and 2 off. This shift is 5 on and 2 off. So it's a lot less days, but I need that now because my body's given up on the 12 day nonsense. It's just about given up on the 5 day nonsense,
yeah,
too. But I just survive it. And these are my, so Monday and Tuesdays are my Saturday and Sunday, so these are my 2 days off. But I have taken off Wednesday and Thursday this week as well because I worked New Year's, so those two stat days I chuck into this. So I'm managing that farm. Comes with a lot more responsibility, but it also comes with a lot more money, and the best perk of all is I don't pay for petrol anymore. So because we don't live on the farm, and we got offered to live on the farm, and we don't want to, we like living in the city now, we're getting used to it. And I like leaving work and getting off the farm and coming home. So because I have to travel to work and back every day, I get free fuel whenever I need it, so I just top up whenever I need it. So obviously yesterday when I finished my shift, I filled up for our trip down here. So not having to go to the petrol pumps is bloody awesome, especially this time of life when it's getting more and more expensive to go anywhere. I don't know what our plans are in Cornwall. We're really just going to sit down, play board games, cards, and drink a shit ton of piss. Everyone's bought alcohol, everyone's bought heaps of food, everyone's bought shots. And so it's a bit of a holiday comes engagement celebration. Hey, babe.
Yeah, I think so.
We were planning to come down here anyway. We planned 6 weeks ago to come down before they even got engaged, but now we'll chuck that into the celebrations as well.
What's that? Free something.
Free manure.
Oh.
You see three and you're like, what's that?
I saw three and I didn't know what it was.
Well, it's free horseshit.
Sure.
For your garden.
Yeah, we don't need that.
No, we don't need that. It was just funny. What was that?
I just saw three, man. It was
free fruit,
I've been
like, turn around. Well, I'll turn you around a little bit. Oh, no, because we're on the old highway. Ryan wants to go this way. This is the old highway that we're taking, not
quite
the...
Nice though.
It's the scenic route.
The scenic route, lots of trees, which I love.
Lots of dead grass.
Yes, lots of dead grass.
When we came down in October a year and a half ago, the mountains we're looking at now had snow on them. Well, obviously now they don't. I'm going to try to crack out my first swim down in Cromwell. The batch we're staying at, or the house, it's a holiday home.
It's an Airbnb, well, actually, and
it's an Airbnb, all right? So
beautiful.
Debbie used to look after this lady's mum when she worked for healthcare, so they've become real good friends. So this Airbnb gets charged out at $390 per night if you want to stay in it. But we don't have to pay anything because Debbie's friends with the owner. So really, we're getting like $1,400 worth of accommodation the next 4 days for free, and it's a beautiful home. I'll take you around and show you.
Very flash.
For us it is anyway.
Just about
died
the first time.
Yeah. And it's right on the lake and Cronwell and stuff like that, so I might do a few bombs. A few manus off the bridge.
Oh yes.
Get Debbie to video. That might not too.
Why not, dear?
Oh, look, I ain't no guarantee. Why don't I put my feet in the water? But,
oh,
yep.
Got all these, on their farm, they've got all these irrigation. Is it irrigator or is it what? Water?
It's just water.
Oh, because it's so friggin' dry. Oh, drop.
So, heaps of irrigators going. Wow. This is how dry it is. This is central, central Otago we're in at the moment. This is the back road. I can't really tell you where we are.
I think that must be kale or something, is it?
I don't know what that is. Looks like bloody cabbages. But the mountain that you can see in front of us right now, that's Ryan's car as well, is covered in snow when we came down last time, where the top of it was. Look at these big irrigating systems to my right here.
Well, isn't that what you've got at work?
Yeah, we've got these at work as well.
Do you know how to work that now?
Yeah, I know how to do it.
Really? How do you do that?
Oh, I'm not going to go into how to do it.
It's massive.
Yeah, it's not that hard actually.
Oh.
Yeah, it's not that hard to do. They just look impressive. No, they're on chains. They pull along themselves on timers. You put them on a timer and they go from certain town. And then you turn around and they come back. So yeah, this is central Otago. We passed a nice fruit shop before. I wanted to go in there, but we didn't. But Hill Springs is here. So yeah, very different down here. The roads and the everything's totally different. And you think that, you know, like it's about an hour and a quarter, hour and 20 minutes out of Dunedin. But it's totally different, eh? It's totally different. The landscape is just totally different. When we get to this area, I don't know what it's called, but it's like real, real rocky. I'll put the video back on and show you guys. But I'll just show you a bit of our holiday, a bit of our trip. Obviously, we won't be uploading this until we get back to our house in 4 days' time. Where we're going to, there is no internet there, just what's on our phones. So that's not a bad thing either. So we'll upload this when we get back home from our holiday. Wow, look at that water. It's freaking stunning.
That's really nice.
Oh, these corners aren't that stunning though. Look at all the rocks and stuff. Sitting out on some beautiful scenery here. I don't know what it looks like on my camera, but there is a place we're going to which is just all rocks. Looks really nice. But this may be an hour and a half, a two hour video, I don't know. But as I'm working now a lot more, I don't make a lot more videos, so I thought what I'd do is I'll definitely pump out a video a month, and it'll probably be like a 2 hour video every time I put one up. Just that between working and other things, it's just, I really can't be bothered, to be honest, making videos every 4 or 5 days. So I thought I'd chuck one up a month. If not more, I might chuck up more a month, but definitely one a month. And, you know, make a two and a half hour video out of it.
Camper
van's
down there.
That must be a freedom camping place. Alright, so we'll come back to you when we are in a different spot to show you some different. I just remember from our drive last time a few places, and I don't know what they're called though, sorry. Alrighty, we'll see you soon. So this is Roxborough.
Oh,
we're gonna stop here by the looks of it.
Okay, then.
Hang on, we'll come back to you very shortly. We're just stopping here for something. I'm not quite sure what we're stopping here for. We'll just find out.
Are we stopping
here
or not?
No?
I don't know, it's Roxborough.
Yeah, I know.
Do you want to stop?
Huh?
No, we're good.
Yeah. Hey guys, we're just talking to Ryan, seeing if we're stopping, but we only stopped like 5 minutes ago.
Mm.
I remember going here because we stopped there, hun. That's where we went for that coffee that time.
Oh, that's right.
Remember?
Yep.
And then Ryan walked down here and got a sausage roll.
Yep.
Down to this place here, and there were these toilets with this. Was it a cool?
Yeah,
there.
Yeah.
That's where we stopped.
Yep.
Sorry guys, we're just buzzing out because this is where we start to remember a few things when we come down. I don't know if you guys can see the low cloud and the hills in front of us. pretty fucking stunning, to be honest.
That's quite nice, yeah.
It's really nice. I know where we are now. I don't know where we are, but I remember going down here.
I think it was probably snow on the mountains last
time. There was snow on the mountains last time, very, very top. So we're planning on coming down again, guys, when we go in the middle of winter. I don't know when, July, August, we'll come down again. If we can get the house again, I'm sure we can get it. Again, we just got to book because it is a B&B, so we've got to book ahead because she gives it to us when she hasn't got customers. But then we can go skiing because it's only 20 minutes, half an hour to, I think it's 40 minutes to Queenstown. And the remarkable ski field's only 20 minutes away from Cronwell. So we'll be able to go skiing. Mum's not going to go skiing, she doesn't like it. She'll sit inside with the fire going.
Yeah.
But we'll go. So yeah, this is part of the scenery. It's really nice. Alrighty, we'll catch up with you again shortly. Hang on, where's Ryan? Now let me just see what Ryan's up to. He's stopping for something. I'm not sure what.
Fruit garden. Cherries. That's what it says. Where does it say that?
Just there. But it's in there, back there.
Yeah, no. Somewhere.
Hang on, we're going to stop it here, guys. Fruit place.
Oh, it's a fruit shop.
So I didn't film that, but we just stopped at a place where it said apricots and peaches and plums and, oh my god, down here, so you can buy them by the kg or you can get a box. We bought a box for $25 and you can fill it, like overfill it, of all the fruit you can. So we just, and this box is not like a Weet-Bix box, it's a big ass box. We filled it with nectarines, plums, peaches, apricots, and we've got some berries as well.
Yeah, that was extra.
But that was extra. It was $5 for a punnet.
Yeah.
But we've got all this fruit. We take it to Cronwell, and then now we know it's there. We're going to buy another box on the way home to eat, and then Mum's going to make some. What do you want to do? Strawberry?
Plum and apricot.
So we're going to, there's big bags you can buy good for, or big boxes you can buy for making jam. So we're going to buy a couple of boxes of pumpkin mix. Jam for us. Yummy. And I'll show you. And here's another fruit store. These are everywhere down here. Just on my left hand side, you'll see now a fruit store. What do we got? We've got peaches, plums, apricots. This is Central Otago, so this is where the wine and all the fruit comes from. And because it comes from down here, it's cheap. Like, it's cheaper than it is in the North Island. And I think that box of $25 we spent would be about $100 worth in the supermarket.
Yeah.
And then you can't get those nice ones in the supermarket either. Whew! We've already scoffed at a couple of apricots, my god. Yeah, if you constipate, you won't be now. I haven't taken a shit today either.
Okie dokie, didn't need to know that.
Now I'm sitting in my, because I'll turn you around, I'm sitting in my hoodie, because in Dunedin it was like 15 degrees and cloudy and spitting. And now I've hit here, I'm just about ready to take it off.
It's not hot, it's just nice.
You can feel the warmth, but I'm starting to.
There's no sun, but you still feel warm.
Yeah, it's really nice. There's no sun at all, it's all just cloud. But it's really warm. Quite humid, which we're not used to in Dunedin. So.
It's toasty warm.
And we just stopped in a place called, was it Milton, huh?
No,
not Milton. We've been through Milton. Roxburgh.
Yeah, that's
Roxburgh.
We went through there,
and then we stopped at that little place there.
Yeah.
So we're about an hour from Cromwell.
It's less than that, actually.
Oh, probably a little bit less than that. So we're in Cornwall, tonight's Monday, so we're starting Monday night, Tuesday night, Wednesday night, go home Thursday, and then I go back to work on Friday for Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and then I have my Monday and Tuesday off again, so, yeah. Cool bananas.
Yeah, Sophie goes back to school on Monday.
Oh yeah, Sophie goes back to school a week today.
Yeah.
And they have to wear masks, I hear. I will do my 2-minute bleat on about this COVID and stuff, and then I'll stop talking about it. I don't know if you guys who are watching follow the news, but we are in the red light or whatever they call it these days, traffic light. All I'm going to say, guys, is just live your life. Just live your life. Please don't get sucked into all this panic buying and staying at home and not going out and freaking out. Okay, just live your life. Like, we're all going on holiday, all right? We're scanning in, we're wearing our masks when we have to, but apart from that, we're still living our lives. Don't get trapped into this situation where you're just going to sit back, sit in your house, isolate, get jabbed, not go anywhere. Don't do it. Just keep living your life, all right? Nothing's changed apart from the gatherings of 100 people or more. Nothing's changed. We don't need to panic, boy. We don't need to panic. We don't need to worry about shit. Just enjoy your life, live your life, and have some fun. Don't get caught up in the drama. That's all I'll say about that.
Yep.
Oh, this is a place where the rocks are, huh? So shortly, guys, we'll come back. You'll take a little bit of a video of one side. There's like grass, and one side looks like Mars. It's just rocks and barren land. I wish you could see what I can see on my right hand side. But I'll stop at the top of the hill and I'll show you a little bit of a video of it. It's really strange. It's like grass, even though it's dead sort of flax grass, Mars, or the moon. It's bizarre. And it's not a summer thing, it was like that in winter. And I spoke to Ryan and asked him, why does it look like that? Like, what's the reason? And they said, because in winter, this place just snows all the time. Just snow on all the hills. So it gets so cold it can't grow anything. And then in summer, it sits at 34, 35 degrees every day. So it burns everything off. So it just looks like Mars 12 months out of the year. Look at it, mate. It goes for miles. It's just barren. Anyway, we'll come back to you shortly. I'm going to put the video, the camera on for a little bit, guys. See if you can see now these rocks I'm talking about with Mars. Looks like Mars. Might be able to see some if you look carefully in certain spots. But keep an eye out. I mean, to my right here, camera's not really picking up, but all those hills over there, it's all barren. It's all barren.
Nice.
That's it, the Cloister. our son in front of us. That little bloody car can boogie, man. What is it, a Holden?
Spark.
Holden Spark. His nana gave him a ring to get married, and his nana gave him that car as well.
Spoiled
little grandson, not. And I'll tell you what, it's only a little tiny car, but it's bloody. When they went up north for 10, 11 days, they left the car with us to look after it. Mum drove it around a little, but not much. But it's a good car to go blading around Dunedin and the Nahum.
Yeah, that's good.
And it's good on fuel. Christmas and New Year. Let me know in the comments what you got up to in New Year's, if you did anything, or for Christmas, what you did. New Year's, we stayed at home. I stayed up till about 12:05, then went to bed because I had work the next day. We didn't go anywhere. Christmas, we went to Ariel's mother and husband's place with her sister as well. That was good. I always hung around home. Didn't do much.
No, we didn't.
Mum is going to get a cat when we get back. She's going to the SPCA and buying a cat. So she was going to get one a while ago, but we knew this trip was coming up. We didn't want to buy a rescue cat and then have to leave it for 4 days when we go away. So yeah, it's not very fair. So we decided that we would go away now, and then once we get back, Mum's going to go onto the site, and because you can't go to the SPCA like you used to, you have to look online at them, read about them, then if you like it, you can go in and make an appointment to see them. But it's not cheap, guys. To buy a cat's $120 or something.
$125 to adopt a cat.
$125.
That's microchipped, neutered, and you know, defleed and all that sort of hoo-ha. So I mean, you know, you're getting a well looked after cat. You're not just getting a piece of, you know, like a kitten. I mean, a kitten is like a
goat. Oh my God! Sorry.
Really?
Sorry. There's a wild goat just standing on a fucking rock. Just standing there.
Oh, that's great.
Just stood there.
I've heard
there's heaps of wild goats here. I just looked and I saw a goat just stand on the side of a rock on the side of the road. A big ass wild goat. Sorry for interrupting, that was just... Anyway, so yeah, I know, but I just got so excited then. Jesus.
I didn't even see the goat.
Holy moly, actually I might go back on my video sometime, see if I can see that.
I don't think you'd be able to see it because it's on the wrong side of the road.
Yeah, probably. Bugger! Jesus, that was exciting. Like, it's quite warm now. Sun's coming out, clouds are clearing.
Nice.
Okay, sorry, so the cat... So, and then Mum wants to get a cat that's an older cat to give it a good, like, rest of its life.
Yeah.
And because we live in an apartment, we want to get a cat that's used to living outside.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
middle-aged,
yeah.
Like us, Bubba.
Yeah.
What's it laid out of sleep all day?
7, 8, 9 years old or whatever.
Yeah.
I don't know how old.
Give it
a good life. Yeah. So that'll be nice. And I don't want a kitten, yeah, so
no.
they cost too much. $200 for a kitten, for goodness sake.
Yeah, but it's just dumb because then you got a toilet train at a... Oh, $200 for a kitten.
You're still going to have to toilet train, eh?
But you've got to let it know where it's...
You've got to let it know where the potty box is and stuff.
Pottiers?
Yep.
Boy, it's barren down here and so dry.
It's very dry, isn't it?
Yeah, I think we're turning here, aren't we? Right, I think we're going off the road, aren't we, here?
Is this where we start?
Yeah, it is.
This is it. This is the spot, I remember that.
Oh. No, it's not, it's that one up there.
Oh, is it? Oh, he stopped. Oh, no. Okay. What's he doing? What are we stopping there for? Okay, there
you go. It's the next one up there.
Sure.
It's this one up here.
It's raw footage, guys.
Yep, raw footage. Righto. Okay, we're arriving in to... Where are we, huh?
Alexandra.
About 30 minutes out of Cronwell. And they've got a... Oh, yeah. You can't see it, but up on the hill.
Where is it?
No, you can't see it. There's a big, huge clock somewhere I saw when we came down last time. This is a beautiful little town. I really like this town. I think if I was to live in any town in New Zealand, it would be this one. It's really pretty. But then in winter, it would be bloody cold. But geez, that sun's warm. I haven't felt that sun. Ryan pointed out to the right hand side there, huh? Ryan pointed to the right. It's just all desert rocks up there.
Yeah.
There is a clock somewhere.
Clock?
I don't know.
Somewhere.
I think we're past where it is.
Is it?
Yeah, our Cromwell, 35k, Queenstown, 95k.
Oh, yeah.
But what a stunning day. I don't know what the temperature is here, but it's bloody warm. Not like Dunedin anymore, I can tell you that much. I don't know where that clock is. It is around here somewhere.
Yeah, it's up in the hills.
I don't know where, though. And our producer's walking across the road in a 3-hour time gap looking at their phone the whole... Oh, did he tripped? He just about tripped over.
Yeah, because he's looking at his fucking phone.
Lift your
then.
Fucking
serious?
Head up, man.
Yeah.
Like, you know,
yeah.
Get off your phone while you're walking across the fucking road at least, bro.
Right.
And what controls the world more than the fucking government? Bloody phones. Jesus Christ almighty.
I know.
It's fucked up though, isn't it?
I know, that's how
I would have been even better if I'd been recording it like I am now and he'd fallen over, would have laughed at him, dickhead. And you're on your phone while walking across a pedestrian crossing, just about trips over.
Camera would have got that one.
I hope camera did get it. Dumbass.
Oh, anyone else can laugh at it.
Hope you're all laughing at that, guys. Don't be one of those dickheads that walk across the road with your head in the phone. Not one text or one message can wait till you walk across the road, surely.
He's probably playing a game.
He's probably playing. He probably was playing a game. Didn't want to die. Didn't want to die on his game, but he'll take the risk with his own life.
Yeah.
Fucking what a winner. You know what, I probably will do a few manus if the weather's like this. It'll be tomorrow, guys. I will not be swimming today. I just decided it's not today. I don't know why. It is only like lunchtime or something. I don't know what time it is actually. What is the time, bud?
It is 1:30.
1:30. Oh, it's too late now. Too late. By the time I get there, it'll be 2 o'clock. Half past 2. Quarter past 2. Yeah, this is a nice town. There's a big clock on... Up on a hill somewhere, but
yeah,
I didn't see it today. You might be able to see it on the way back.
Yeah.
And now we're going to go and we're going to stop at the Clyde's Dam. Is that it, hun?
Yeah.
The Clyde's Dam. We're not actually stopping at the dam itself, just the water park.
Yeah. Is it the Clyde Dam or the Clutha? No.
Oh, it's the Clutha, is it? No, it's a
no,
Clyde.
No, it's
only
the Clyde. Yeah, sorry.
Clyde. Not giving any of my North Island viewers shit, because most of you are from the North Island, but the South Island, I'm sorry, the scenery down here is just the next level than the North Island. I mean, we've lived in the North Island for 48, 9 years of our lives, so we can say we've been all around, we've been everywhere. We've been the top of the North, bottom of the North, all around the North, but the scenery down here, you're in a whole new level of there's still snow on the mountain, and look.
Is there really?
Look, right ahead of us, there's little gaps of little bits of snow. But yeah, sorry if the phone's jigging around a bit, it's just the road. But yeah, the South Island scenery, guys, is just, we're at a whole new level altogether. And then one thing we are going to be doing at wintertime when we come down and go skiing, we're going to go to Queenstown and have a look around, but Ryan really wants us to go to that other place, huh? Where he said it's the most beautiful place. He said you'll literally cry with how stunning it looks. Okay. What is it?
No idea.
Not Wanaka? Oh, there's a place somewhere. No. It's got glaciers and snow and waterfalls.
Milford Sound,
maybe, I think it is. So we're going to do that in the winter time as well.
That'll be beautiful.
It will be stunning, eh?
Yeah.
Well, this is really... So the hills you're looking at ahead of us, guys, right now, when we came down in October, they at the top of them had snow on. And when we come down in winter, those whole mountains will be covered in snow, which will also look beautiful. But this sun, I haven't felt heat like this for quite some time, and I'm really enjoying it. Right, we just stopped here for some family portraits and photos. Ariel's got a professional camera and all that sort of stuff. This is a, oh, I forgot the dam again. Oh, a Clutha?
Clyde.
Clyde Dam. Oh, it's absolutely beautiful. And I probably sound like I am because I'm sweating. It's so warm. All of a sudden, it's just got really, really hot. I'm going to click on my car thing in a minute and tell you what the temperature is once I get off this bit of road. Oh my god, that's really warm. How do I find out? I don't know how to find out. There's a button here I can push on my dash that tells me. 21 degrees.
Oh, really?
See, now you might think, oh, that's not that warm. But when you've been in Dunedin and you're sitting at 15 or 16 with southerlies, and then all of a sudden you get no wind and 21 degrees and just pure heat, well, feels a lot hotter than 21. Next stop, Cronwell. We're about 20 minutes away. Absolutely stunning. Couldn't pick, but it's just the hills and the water and it's everything.
Yeah,
look at it. I mean, it's just everything about it.
Yeah.
It's so beautiful, really.
Yeah.
Imagine the middle of winter. Man, it's going to look nice. It's bloody awesome. I'll try to turn this phone around a bit, guys, so you can get a bit more of a landscape than what we can see. So everything that you can see now is barren. Like, it's just hills and rocks. It's covered in snow in wintertime. So yeah, everything you can see now will be covered in snow. Well, not the road, obviously, but the hills. Okay, we've made it. We've got some bikes to go for a bike ride. Let's do a quick little zip around. This is our room. This is our own bathroom, ensuite. It's just sickening, isn't it? How bloody beautiful it is. Sorry, Bubba. Another bathroom. Bedroom. Another bedroom with the same door out to the lake. Lounge, main entrance, kitchen, outdoor eating area, Oh, there's our Barbie for the night. Alrighty, so we've made it to Cornwall. Some bikes we can use, which I'm sure we're going to. Mum's already got washing on. So we'll take you for a look at our room. Mum's making the bed. So this is our room. We've got a little wardrobe and our own ensuite. And these are our doors that open up. That bridge I'll show you later on. I'll get Mum to record it. Me and Ariel are going to do some jumps off that bridge. Probably tomorrow. Another bathroom there. Sophie's room. And Ariel and Ryan's bedroom. They've got the same setup as us. With a sliding door outside. This is the lounge area. The dining room, kitchen area. It's really good because you've got the fridge there, and then you've got another area, pantry thing here, and then we've got our, we've made this our beer fridge for the next few days. And then this fridge just has like the food in the freezer and stuff like that we put in it. So we bought all our own food. We're here for 3 days and we want to eat heaps. This is a fruit I was talking about before on the channel that we went and bought for a box of $25. That's part of it. And then we've got someone, some there as well. And this is the outside, the barbecue. And that's the section and this is the lake. And that's the bridge that we're going to jump off there tomorrow. So we'll make sure we get that footage for you. And this is how she looks. That's the main bridge there into Cornwall itself. And all these hills here you can see here, like all up here, way over the mountains over there. But all these hills here are covered in snow in winter. So we'll show you that in winter when we come back down. But that's the place where we're staying. Pretty bloody nice, isn't it?
Come on, babe, you can get in.
Oh.
Come on, you can do it. All your followers on YouTube, or subscribers, or whatever they are.
I'm not standing here.
Yeah, well, you still have to do it.
I'm not standing here.
Well.
It's cold.
Okay, I know I'm a bok. I'm not even getting in, but that's just me.
I wish I could just run up and push it.
I know, right?
I mean,
yeah, I'm enjoying it.
Dad, come on! I mean,
come on, babe!
It's enough videoing.
Really?
You can edit it.
I'm putting this on my story.
I'm ready for a swim.
Yeah, but everybody knows that you're a...
Would you rather jump off the bridge first?
A bok chicken.
He wants to go on the bridge.
You want to jump off the bridge? Seriously?
You can actually just walk in properly. Like, what a...
I'd rather just jump off here.
How do you get out there?
You just walk alongside. Up here and along.
What a noob.
Can I jump off the bridge? Oh, I can't manage it. I'm chilling. Dad, I'm really comfortable. Are you comfortable?
Okay.
It's nice.
It is, it's really nice. You'll get used to it quickly. Come on, Ben, you used to dive. Get your arm.
Dad, just go. Come on, bro. You're the one who said you wanted to swim.
You need to hold your hand, walking.
You must hold your hand.
No, you're wet, me. Are you videoing this?
Yeah, of course.
No.
Yes. It's raw footage!
Yeah. This is a real thing that's happening.
Yeah.
Oh my god!
Oh my god.
Behind the scene. Okay, we get it.
Balls are cold.
Okay, you're gonna be like.
Oh my god.
Behind the scenes of what actually happened.
Careful at the bottom, don't dive yet. Now I'm giving you 30 seconds or we're coming to get you.
No, give me a minute.
No, I'm giving you 60 seconds.
No.
60 seconds.
That's a minute.
And I'm coming to get you.
Oh gosh. Oh, there he goes. There we go. Whee! And he's in. Woohoo! Okay, we stop that now.
So what do we got? We've got corn, salad. Garlic bread, what do we got?
You put that in the salad.
Salad.
You can if you want to, but I know that they don't.
Couple of boxes of shots for tonight. Alcohol galore. More in there. We've just been for a swim in the lake. Fucking beautiful, actually. What's Ryan doing? Sausages, bacon. Dinner served. Oh. Yeah. Come down to, so the place we're staying at is just up top of the hill here, and we have a picnic table, and this is what we have, a table to stand sit at as we have our lunch. This is about a minute walk from our house we're staying in, a jetty, and then an area to go swimming. And don't tell me that life's not good. Work hard, play hard, but oh mine, I just got no words. We've just come down from the house we're staying at. The house we're staying at is just up here, like it's about a minute up there, and we've just come down here to a little jetty, and this is what we can see. Absolutely beautiful. Wowee. Yes, I probably will hop in the water again sometime.
You guys want to
one? Everyone's out there now. Even Mum's got her togs on and she's got her feet in the water.
Rocks.
It is very cold apparently. I have not been in, obviously, because I'm the biggest chicken shit there is. Ariel just fucking like a mermaid. Swims like there's no tomorrow, doesn't care. That's Sophie. Ryan's out there. Is it cold, babe?
It's cold, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, Mum.
And in winter, this all is mountain here. It's all covered in snow in wintertime. That's why it looks so barren now.
It's a beautiful day to be with you. It's a beautiful day to be with you. Oh, when I see your face, it's true. The skies are brighter blue. It's a beautiful day to be with you.
Gonna do some bombs in the water.
Above, I'm telling, safe.
Yeah. Woohoo! Wee-hee! Yay!
Big bottle, nah.
Not really. He didn't do much of a big splash. Not really.
No?
He didn't do much of a big splash. Oh, I'm so... Oh, we go again. Not really, eh? So he doesn't have the bottom. It's pretty shallow, though. That's why. He doesn't want to break his neck. So no necks were broken in this time. No. What are you doing? No, they're gonna do a swim or some bullshit. I don't know what they're doing. Yeah. Yes, I'm recording. She's gonna beat you hands down. Seriously, hun? She's a water person, you're not. I don't know why you did that. She's gonna smash your fucking ass.
No, I wasn't trying.
Oh, bullshit.
Oh, I'm out of breath.
Okay.
More pressure, I suppose.
So I asked her if she wanted to go and live with you
full time.
What, Sophie? Yeah.
You asked what?
I asked her if she wanted to go and live with you guys
full time.
And what did she say?
She didn't really say anything.
So we've left Cornwall. We've been there 3 nights, 4 days, heading home. We had to do a pit stop. On the way, we just had to visit a place in Alexander, the Alexander Tyre shop. We the front steering wheel's been shaking, and I had a real good look at the tyres, and I was like, both front tyres on the outside, it's due for its warrant, so I had a look. The back tyres are fine, the front two on the front were bald. I was like, oh, we need to get them replaced. So I rang up, I would say the best deal I've ever had on tyres ever. So $300 for, was it $300?
Yeah,
$290 for two front tyres, new tyres, balanced and all that stuff. And when they took them off, they showed me the tyres, and there was actually wire hanging off both sides than inside. So very fortunate that we got those tyres done today. And the reason I did get them today is because I did Google tyres in Dunedin and found out they were like $249 each, and how much they were here. They're only $145 each here. So two of them. So pretty good. And now the car feels very light and racy again.
Yeah.
So, now that Ryan and Ariel have gone ahead of us. I don't know where they are. We're about 20 minutes behind them, but we're going to stop somewhere for coffee and something to eat.
Yeah.
We enjoyed our time there. Back to work tomorrow. Sophie's off to school on Monday. Can't show you it because it's there, but you can see the snow on the top of the hills, which wasn't here 2 days ago, and the low clouds now snowing on top of the hills as we drive. Really cool. And if you want to, I've seen them covering this corner. If I turn the, no, it's that side. I'll turn around and see anything.
See, yeah.
I am heading towards the snow. I'm going to pick this up and show you guys the very, very top. Can you see the snow on the top of the mountain? It's actually snowing now as we speak. And it's got horrifically cold all of a sudden. Like really cold. We're coming back down here again in winter to stay there, and it'll be snow all around us. And we buzz out on snow because we don't really have ever really had any snow around us.
Yeah.
So it is really cool. I'll show you this, guys. Check this. Obviously there's no snow this low, but it's above us now. But no, we've thoroughly enjoyed our holiday. I would love another day at home actually before I go back to work, but it is what it is.
Is that snow?
It's snow on our windows, on our window. Yeah. Only tiny little drips, you guys probably can't see them. But yep, there was no snow there 2 days ago. Look at it now.
Yeah.
And it's still January.
It's so cold for a bit.
Yeah, we are. We don't know what to expect in winter for coldness. We've been told how cold it gets, but we're going to have to wait and see. So it's still a beautiful drive, a bit more overcast and cloudy today.
The sun is there though.
Yeah, it is. Oh, there they get a chuck. Makes you really hungry.
Yeah, I'm quite hungry actually.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I need a coffee too.
Yeah.
I think the next town we're going past is Roxburgh, I think.
Yeah, it is Roxburgh.
Well, we have to keep an eye out for that fruit shop.
We yeah, I'm not fruit. Sure where was that?
I don't know. Hopefully we don't bloody pass it and forget.
Oh no, there's like three or something on there.
Yeah, we do. So yep, heading back home now. Only a couple of hours away. This one's four wheel. Oh, and these little cruising around, look at them. It's quite windy, it's quite windy. That snow is, looks really cool, man, that dumping of snow up there. Yeah, so that's, yeah, everyone's tired. The bed, we like soft beds. The bed was really hard. Like, I keep calling it the brick. It was like laying on brick. It's very hard.
Really hard.
And I broke the shower this morning. I don't know how I turned the fucking shower on and the hose like, snapped in half. I don't know what I did, I just turned it on. But yeah, not much to say really. Catch up with you a bit later on, I think. So we've made it home. Not sad about it at all. It was a great time away, but it's nice to come home. Come home to a couple of tomatoes that are red and one orange. We stopped at a place, where was that fruit place, hun?
Roxburgh.
And because Dunedin, you can't really get a lot of fruit, to be honest. And we bought, so you get this box here for $25 and you can fill it as much as you want. So you get like, we just got nectarines and peaches and plums and apricots. It's filled up there. Mum, I got some cherries and our big ass fruit bowl's full as well. Oh yeah. Oops, sorry my fingers. So we'll leave the video there guys. I hope you've enjoyed it. I didn't take a lot of footage as you saw in Cronwell, but we were just doing our own thing. Yeah, we didn't go anywhere. We were gonna go to Arrowtown and do some gold panning, but we just hung out at the house and swam and ate and drank and played Monopoly and stuff like that. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, give it a thumbs up, let me know in the comments, and if you want to see something else around here, let me know. Otherwise we'll catch you next time.